Good evening, friends. I am Dayanand Nene and I welcome you all to this part 5 of our Sahakar Sutra series on deemed conveyance. In this part, friends, we shall take information about what exactly happens when the society formally makes an application with the Deputy Registrar's office seeking deemed conveyance. But before that, let us look at the first two stages before we actually discuss about the application part. In the first phase, we have discussed, friends, that the Managing Committee of a society passes a resolution in their meeting to call for a general body and take approval from its members that the society should formally seek deemed conveyance from the Deputy Registrar's office. So, once the special general body meeting is called for the purpose, the first resolution which the Managing Committee puts forth and adopts in that meeting is that the society is formally seeking deemed conveyance from the office of Deputy Registrar. Once that resolution is passed, a second resolution is adopted seeking members' contributions for the expenses which would be incurred while seeking deemed conveyance. After that, the society has to pass a resolution appointing one member as their authorized representative of the society to deal with the matter with the Deputy Registrar's office. And finally, the society passes another resolution appointing a legal consultant to look into various aspects, the legal aspects of deemed conveyance at the office of the Deputy Registrar. Once this stage one is over, the society then, in the stage two, prepares for all the documents which are required while making the application for deemed conveyance. We have discussed these two aspects so far. Now, in this episode, we go on to the third aspect. The society, after it is ready with the documentation, actually files its application for deemed conveyance with the competent authority, that is the office of the Deputy Registrar. The Registrar's office then vets the application, and in case they find any mistake in the application, they give society 15 days to rectify the mistake and file a correct application once again. Once the society's application is received, the Registrar's office then issues a notice to the builder and asks his formal reply as to why the Registrar's office should not give deemed conveyance to the society. If the builder responds, then the Registrar's office decides on a hearing, the hearing number one, wherein he calls both the parties, the builder or the landowner and the cooperative housing society, and hears both the parties' side regarding conveyance. Then the Registrar gives both of them a time of 1 month and asks them to file their respective replies on the matter. Then comes the second hearing. If the builder, as happens in most of the cases, absents himself or boycotts these hearings, then in the second hearing, the Registrar's office takes the society's response, and in lack of response from the builder or the landowner, decides that they have nothing to say on the matter, and he decides to post the matter for a third hearing after a month for orders on the society's application. The third and the final hearing comes up in front of the office of Deputy Registrar after that 1 month period, and in that the Registrar's office and the deputy registrar passes an order giving deem conveyance in favor of the society, and that completes the matter at the office of the registrar. Then the stage 4, the deem conveyance deed, once adjudicated, is properly stamped and registered, and then it goes to stage 5, wherein the transfer of property takes place in the records of the Land and Revenue Department. This entire process of from filing the application till the order is passed takes approximately about 6 months. Friends, the Maharashtra government has decided to start an awareness drive from 1st of January 2021 till 15th of January 2021 to create awareness amongst societies that they should go for deem conveyance. Just be very clear in your mind, this is purely an awareness campaign. Don't be under any illusion that you are going to get conveyance within 15 days. No, it just cannot happen. As I have explained it in the earlier episodes, the entire process starting to end takes at least 1 year. 6 months for the society, depending on its size, to prepare documentation, and the next 6 months at the registrar's office, as I have explained today. This particular drive is just to create awareness amongst the managing committees of societies about the benefits of deem conveyance and why societies must get the land transferred in its name, so that in future they do not face any problems if they have to go in for reconstruction or redevelopment. Sahakar Sutra applauds the Maharashtra government for taking this step. We also have been actively pursuing the matter and promoting the concept of deem conveyance amongst cooperative societies, and this particular series is meant to create awareness and discard any false notions about deem conveyance. We hope that this series will be helpful to all cooperative housing societies who are watching this, and in the new year they not only pass a resolution but get the land and property conveyed on their respective society's name. Wishing you all a very happy new year. Thank you very much.